Uncle Poseidon.
I have to tell you something, little Hades. My relatives and I, we've been holding back one of our greatest gifts to see if you were worthy. And you are. My aid is yours. So call me if you need anything.
Oh, what's this? Of Poseidon at my beck and call. Composed of such innumerable, ever-shifting, interlocking chambers, the underworld of Lord Hades all but guarantees the dead shall there remain until the end of time. Good thing I'm not dead. That's something. Numbskulls. Back to dust. For a bit.
have to eat.
Pom power.
Let's see. Why not?
Stone. Just great.
You have slain more than 100 foes since you began your quest. You have, for I am keeping count, and I am most impressed.
To fight.
Good morning, or whenever.
Hey, sir.
You know, Princette, I'd not expected to run into you again, not after all this time. Something amiss down in the house, or what? Not had much company of late, is all.
Oh, something's just about always amiss back home, sir. Figured it couldn't hurt to check up on things in Tartarus a bit more frequently.
Well, I am grateful for it, I and the old boulder there, in turn. I'm used to going lengthy stretches on my own, but having visitors from time to time would do me well. Most excellent.
A pleasure.
Within the depths of Tartarus reside the most wretched of all the shades who linger for eternity within the underworld, whose lord and master is especially unkind to those attempting to cheat death.
Lots of wretchedness to go around, I guess.
Farewell, Highness.
Out of my way. That must be one of those infernal traps. Stop me. Modified. Let's try it.
Interloper!
You lad, huh? That. Never enough of these back at the house. Thank you.
dead.
A weapon back at home.
From long ago, young man. I've no more need of it, of course, but how you found it, you shall have to tell me once you're here.
All right, Lord Zeus.
Stubborn, aren't you? Maybe my whip might make you reconsider whatever it is that you're attempting here.
Your whip's not been all that persuasive in the past.
Maybe persistence will pay off for both of us. Come. You get. my regards.
I'll get you for that, Meg.
My child.
I heard lately from the goddess Athena, Nix. She seems to admire you. I thought...
They typically do not. But you are family, child. And I believed Athena wise enough to understand why someone such as I would seek her in particular.
You make a good team. Now we're talking. Don't have enough keys.
Felt nothing there, sorry.
Ready as I'll ever be. Crashing waves, the trident. The power of the sea.
Delves back into the underworld, its ever-shifting chambers realign to frustrate his attempts to perhaps map it out.
Built to ensure no one gets out. We'll see about that. Gemstones. Wretches. can unlock a weapon back at home. Let's go, lads. Let's see here. Hi there. In the name of Hades, Olympus, I accept this message.
Why, hello, hello there, little godling. I have to say, you're quite the specimen, and so I've decided I shall aid you for the moment. You and...
Interesting. And the power to break hearts? I'm sure I don't see why not. tombstones. Something back home. Open up.
That was ill-advised.
Charon, mate. Now, hypothetically, if I provided you with, say, 1,000 coins, would you be willing to give me a ride in your beautiful boat? Upriver, I should say, specifically. I had to ask. You like it, mate? Thank you for helping me out with your supply, even if you fleece me with those prices. Should help keep you going.
Looks like we meet again, dearest, here among the foul detritus of the boatman's wares.
Something for the mirror. Can't get rid of me, Meg.
And there you are.
I'm sure he'd well.
I have no envy for your father's position. Besides, I...
blood.
Father. Bad time to be a little short of coin. I can wash away my boons. Gone this far. Good. Now we're getting somewhere. It's nice and warm out here, I'll give it that. Slam dancers. Keep going.
attack again.
Olympus knows of him, bestowing on him all their worthless blessings here within my realm. Our realm. Explain to me how exactly this is possible, Nyx.
Do not question my power, Hades. Your son was bound to be discovered the closer he came to the surface. The Olympians are pleased to know they have a distant relative and bid him welcome to their mountain. That is all. Their influence is very limited.
Blood and darkness, do not speak to me about their influence. I've seen their influence firsthand. You've made a foolish mistake.
You would speak to me of foolish mistakes. You cannot change the course that has been set. Try all you like.
Nyx.
On my authority, I'd like it if you did this job for me. Is that all right?
I want to go lie down.
See you, Mira.
It is the dead of night, or the approximation of it in the realm of Hades. Prince of the underworld, Zagreus, rises from a fitful slumber, with much mischief on his mind.
Mischief? Me? I was just going to have a little look through Father's stuff.
All is quiet at this time. Ever-dreaming Hypnos put a spell upon the house, as willful Zagreus had asked of him. All are fast asleep, save for the prince.
Lower your voice, old man. I'm trying to be sneaky here.
He ventures toward the stately throne of his lord father, half expecting to be caught, but ill expecting what he is about to find.
I said shut up, old man.
He does not know exactly what he seeks. He only knows that something always has felt off to him, that he does not belong. Who is he, really? Lord Hades never would indulge such questions. So Prince Zagreus would find out for himself.
I'm not listening.
He rifles through his Lord Father's possessions. There is not much of any import there. Ledgers and administrative parchment work. Correspondence from Olympus which he had ignored. No trace of any reference to his son. But then, there is the note. Written finally in a hand and voice the likes of which the prince had never seen or heard.
Hades, I can no longer tolerate my life here in this place. So I'm leaving, even if it kills me. I won't be returning to Olympus. If there is a place where I belong in this world, it must be somewhere between heaven and hell. Perhaps it's on the coast and has a little garden. Take care of Cerberus. I shall miss him. Persephone.
Thus did Prince of the Underworld Zagreus absorb the contents of this hidden letter, written in his mother's hand.
His mother's hand? My mother's hand? Wait, what? You're saying this Persephone, that she's my mother? But Father always said that Nyx was that liar. He lied to me. They both did. All my life.
Thus did the prince discover, inadvertently, the well-kept truth about his lineage. Entirely by chance, this did occur. Persephone, the one-time queen of all the underworld. Where had she gone? And why? Engulfed by newfound questions and his rage, the prince decided to confront his lord and master.
You... why? You're... Nix, you're not my mother. All this time, you and my father, you lied to me?
Oh, my dear child. So now you know. But only half the truth. I can explain the rest, so... please.
Mother, I wonder, will you even remember me?